My name is Maverick Sabre, backstage at Royal Studios. When I was like 14, 15, I got into MC on an Irish hip hop scene. And I thought my normal name was a bit plain, so I looked for my two words that would match my initials, and a thesaurus. And felt Maverick for M, which was like someone who thinks outside the box or something, wanting to do what they use.
Okay.
And then for S, I found Sabre, right? And I've never ever been able to find this meaning. But at the time, the meaning that I found was someone who puts on a hard in front to get you hard of times. And I felt like I'd had to do that and still have to do that. So I represented that in my music, so that would represent me as an artist. So the name and then the stock of it. My dad brought me up on traditional like Irish music, Southern American blues and rock and roll. Literally let me open up his record collection and I fell in love with music. So like, I was kind of brought up on like Ray Charles, traditional Irish music, then I'd go to the Beach Boys, the Beatles, and then when I was like 12, 13, I fell in love with hip hop, more kind of modern soul, love stuff like Erica would do in the Roots. And then along the way, fell in love with reggae, dance music, so that's literally a mixture of everything thrown into my music. I think it's probably good. My dad, Tupac, Bob Dylan, Bob Marley. I try and keep it in there as much as possible. I think some people that hear that know a bit of like, traditional Irish music can say to me, or they can hear a tiny bit, which I'm really happy about. But I try and bring a certain element, you know, even if it's in the way I sing. You know, a lot of like old Irish singers sing quite similarly to like maybe reggae, you know, special pronunciation and stuff like that. So people get it quite confused with me, especially with the way I say certain things as well. See, I'm definitely trying to keep that element, that's part of me, you know.
Something good and I need them. No skies I need them. No old times I need. Something good, yes, something good. Yes, something good, yes, something good. You know, you know, no.
Isle of Wight Festival. It was the first festival I started this year. I can't even remember, it was a couple of weeks ago. And I went out and there was like 8,000 people packed up, the tent chanting my name. And it was a big moment for me, like, because last year, if I would have done that set, I wouldn't even got that set at all. Like, so it was a big moment for me. And I'm playing tunes, like, I've got a tune called I Need, that I'm all about living in Ireland, wanting some sunshine, right? It's raining so much. And then for people like 8,000 people to have their hands up and like singing it and stuff like that was a big moment. I love piano and I'm trying to teach myself a bit more.
Okay.
But I love piano. I'd love to learn how to play the tin whistle. Or any like flute or something like that. Or I'd love to know how to play saxophone. So tin whistle or saxophone.
One track,
Window Seat. I met Erica at the Naz and David Marley show. She was lovely, like, but yeah, Erica. I just love London. It's a melting pot, isn't it? You know what I mean? I don't know, I love it. I love the unity here, like, between people. And that's what I've always loved about London. Obviously, there's sort of bad sex. You're going to get some bad sex in every city. But yeah, I love the mixture of everyone, all different cultures. You know, I love the fact that on one street you can get a curry in the Caribbean, takeaway, you know. I love that. You know, and then down the road you can get a Chinese and a Greek meal. Then you can go into a cafe and get baked beans. You know what I mean? You know, I love the mixture. This is Maverick Sabre, and you're watching and listening to Society HAE.